Hey everyone, welcome to this video. Sean Smith here from PPCAMSAccelerator.com, and today I'm going to talk about increasing profit from $63,000 to $81,000 in 15 days with Amazon PPC. I'm going to talk about how I did it. Before I jump in, please do me a quick favor, hit the like button, really helps with the YouTube algorithm, and I would really greatly appreciate it. Also, before I get started, if you have any Amazon PPC questions that you want to be answered, put them in the comments. I will answer them. So basically, if you put a question in the comment, I'll feature it in one of my videos, like in the next video. The reason I'm not doing that right now is just because I haven't gotten a lot of questions in the comments, so I haven't been able to feature anyone. I did it, I can't remember, a few videos ago. So if you have any questions, just pop them in the comments. It'd give me ideas for content as well. All right, so let's dive right in. So what I want to go through is, in this video, what I'm going to show you is the before results, the after results, and the changes, the Amazon PPC changes I made to get those results. Get out of here. Using good old Canva. Okay, so let's open up the screenshot. So this is from a tool called Seller Board that Amazon sellers use to measure profitability. This is before. So this is June 1st to June 15th. So I did 15 days before the changes and 15 days after the changes. So June 1st to June 15th by day, we can see that our sales were $377,515. Net profit was $52,253. But before I do that, I want to let you know that these numbers are not 100% accurate, correct? 100% accurate. And you can see these 2 days right here. And I'm going to go over why and how I adjusted for the inaccuracy here. So you see that circle there? That shows where they were inaccurate. Let me hop in real quick to show you. So we had FBA storage fees, which are added in bulk one time. So during this right here where I circled it, this day right here and this day right here, we had FBA storage fee and inbound transportation fees that I had to account for in the profitability number. So this number right here, the net profit and the margin is incorrect. So the real numbers are 63,146, and the margin is 16.73%. So wanted to just get that out of the way to let you guys know. So the reason, all right, so let me go over how we ended up in the before and after. In the before, you know, I was working with a client, and basically they wanted me to increase spend for a specific product, and just to see if it would help with increased sales volume and profitability. What we saw when we increased spend for relevant keywords, we saw an increase in spend, we saw an increase, slight increase in ACOS, and we did see an increase in sales velocity, but we did not see an increase in profitability. And our hypothesis is that, you know, number one, the market itself is shrinking. Right? The market itself is shrinking is because of the economy. The economy is going down, and so the demand is down as well. I think another variable is what we saw in the data is that the increase in spend for relevant keywords, highly relevant targeted keywords, did not yield the type of returns that we wanted. And this told us that the rank did not stick, or that even if we were ranked better, we didn't necessarily get more sales velocity, right? So ultimately, we just were not getting the results that we wanted. And I'm gonna go over the next 15 days. So that's what happened the first 15 days. We were really trying to push a specific product, and it was a major driver of ours as well. So this is profit before, and this is profit after. You can see that even sales are lower. So let me show you some. $377,515 before. $349,320. So actually our sales are lower, right? But what we noticed was that our profit actually went up. So the actual profitability is 63,146, right? Because we've accounted for some fees that were added that were at the beginning of the month that you can see here weren't added at the back end of the month. So net profit is 81,000 and margin is 23%. Now that's massive compared to 63,000 and 16.73%. So we're seeing that even though our sales are down, our margin's up drastically. And what did we do to get there? Well, we really, so I'm going to step back and how I had to think about this. I didn't want to just kill all of our velocity, right? I didn't just want to kill all of our velocity. So I had to think like strategically, what are the best ways to do it? Well, we know like bringing down budgets, so there are a couple ways to do this. There's pausing campaigns, there's decreasing budgets, and there's decreasing bids as well. And we actually used all three. So in the beginning, we paused some high ACOS campaigns. Like basically what was happening was the spend was too high. And so we were pausing campaigns and then also decreasing budgets. And we had to really like do this quite frequently until we got towards our target. So like, you know, I'd basically pause a high ACOS campaign and then I would, and then decrease some budgets. Now, one thing I did do is use the bulk file to pause campaigns, decrease budgets, and change bids. That way we have those before and after. In case we saw negative results, we could revert back to the original state. And, you know, like for example, with the budgets, what I would do is I would filter by like, because, you know, sometimes you'll have campaigns that have really low budgets and you don't want to decrease them lower. So what I did was like find a number, like any campaigns that have like a budget of $10 or more. And then I would decrease that by like 25%, right? To like 750. And so I was using things like that, like, because I didn't like, and then if they're 750, I don't want to decrease them even further, right? The lowest I'd probably go is like $5. So I might decrease them a little further, but you don't want to get down to a dollar, right? Especially if it's producing sales at a good ACOS. So, you know, decreasing budgets using that type of filtration methodology and also decreasing bids by between 10 and 20%. I didn't want to just like kill bids drastically, because what it might have done is it might have just completely killed off sales because our bids are so low that they're not competitive with the ad auction. So what we did see though when we decreased the bids was we saw, I mean, spend did go down. We saw a decrease in ACOS and we saw a decrease in cost per click, which tells us we didn't necessarily need to pay as much for those clicks. So keep in mind, you can be overpaying for a click, right? You can overpay for a click. That's something to note. So, and we were in situations where the cost per click equals the bid. So what does that tell me? If the cost per click equals the bid, that means that there's a likelihood that we dictate the cost of the ad auction. So we could bring that number down and bring down our cost per click and not necessarily affect traffic. Now, I haven't necessarily tested that scientifically, but that's the hypothesis behind that. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it gave you some knowledge and wisdom. And, you know, the biggest thing for me is we're going through a tough time. And, you know, a lot of Amazon sellers are struggling. And so making sure that we are able to help them pivot in this economy and work towards their goals is our job, right? As for me, as like someone who manages PPC for other people and serves them, my goal is to help them work towards their goals. All right, guys. If you like this video, please express your like by clicking the like button. It would really help me out. And again, if you have any questions about Amazon PPC, pop them in the comments and I will answer them. And I will, so what I'll do is I'll not only feature your comment in the video, but once I do that, I will actually share the video with you. That way you can watch it. I'll share it. I'll reply to you in the comments and share the video. That way you can have it yourself as well for your reference. All right, guys, until next time.